Nicely with Martin Besser.
See some questions coming in. Where is Liesl? And will she be back on the top 20 at least tomorrow? Well, you know what? Let's call her up. Find out what she's up to. What is happening in her life? I think it's fair to share. Liesl?
Mora.
How's that?
I'm well, Mart. How are you?
I'm okay, thank you. Are you at the Olympics? Are you representing us in skateboarding, maybe? No.
Breakdancing.
Breakdancing. What am I thinking?
100%.
Of course. You're quite a dancer. No, none of the above. In fact, a lot less glamorous and fun than that. Shame, peace, man. I'm so sorry. Tell everybody.
Ahmad, over the weekend, myself and my fiancé started feeling a little bit under the weather, him more than me. And he tested positive on Sunday, and I tested positive on Monday, tested positive for COVID-19.
And the symptoms you're experiencing, I mean, I can hear that you sound quite nasal, quite flu-y.
Well, for me, for the first couple of days, we assumed that I was asymptomatic because I was perfectly fine. Even on the Saturday, I still get a gym session. At home, I thought I would be perfectly fine. And on Monday, or rather Sunday evening, it hit me like a bus.
Really?
Very, very warm, had extreme night sweats, nasally, chesty, major, major headache, and hectic back and body pain for myself.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
and,
yeah.
And the smell and taste and all that, which other symptoms?
Oh, no, at least smell and taste. I think if I had lost my smell and taste, I would have lost my entire mind because, you know, I love food and I love to eat. And when I'm not well, eating for me is that's how I grew up. Oh, my pussy, yeah, it's lekker and I'm sloppy. Yeah, so at least I could taste.
And tell me, just in terms of the symptoms, I think people are still trying to figure it out, you know, and kind of get some kind of, not method or rhythm behind it all. Is this more kind of the Delta variant symptoms, the massive headaches and stuff? Or is it just all the same, really?
I believe so, because the taste and smell has been perfectly fine with me. The chest hasn't been as hectic, but the body aches, the headaches, and the on and off fever. I think I've had a fever on and off every day. Three or four times, yes. I'd wake up and I'm fine, and by lunchtime I have a fever. Then by supper time it's really hectic, and then it breaks before I sleep. Then I have night sweats throughout the night, and I wake up in the morning and it feels like I've been run over by a car. Like my body would be in extreme pain.
Oh, man, I am so, so sorry. Good thing, it's like good news, bad news. Good news is you've got a doctor on call.
I do 24/7 call right here.
Bad news, he's also got COVID. Are you on speaker there? Do you want to hand the phone to him quickly, if you don't mind?
I'll borrow him my phone.
Liesl's fiance, Dr. Musa Ntombeni, morning.
Good morning, Martin. Good morning to you. Good morning, everyone listening.
How are you?
I'm a little bit better. I'm feeling a little bit better. The sun looks a little bit brighter. The air is not as cold anymore. So it sounds like we're on our way to recovery.
And just, a lot of questions around essential workers, doctors, having been vaccinated, which I'm presuming that you were vaccinated.
Yeah.
The Johnson & Johnson jab. And then still picking up COVID. A lot of misperceptions around that still, hey?
Oh, yeah, I'm so glad that, I mean, we're on this morning to discuss it. So a lot of people have got this misconception that, you know, once you've got, you know, the jab, it's a cure, you know, that you're going to go out and be Superman and not even flu will get you. And that's such a terrible thing to think about. I mean, it's just like immunizations and things such as that we tell people about. You know, when you try to explain, you know, how vaccines work, a lot of people listen half-heartedly because they're waiting for you to say that big line where you say, but it doesn't stop you from getting COVID. And so you see, what's the point? Then let's just leave it, you know, leave me to, you know, not get jabbed. And the important thing here is, and I think with me, that's what I noticed, is that because I'd gotten the jab and you've seen people that have COVID and, you know, the severe slash mild slash, you know, sort of moderate symptoms that they've had. When I first started feeling a little bit funny, maybe about, you know, Friday evening, I automatically knew what's going on. Like, I mean, I was a bit hesitant at first. I was like, I don't like this peely sore throat that I have. But also last week's weather was a bit terrible.
Sure.
Also, you know, maybe it's flu because I hadn't gotten my flu shot this year. So I was like, I'll see. But I remember I was sitting and my back just started heating up. And I was like, nope, I know exactly what this is. And I said it to Lisa. I was like, hey, Lisa, I'm feeling a little COVID-y. And she's like, no, baby, don't say that. You're going to be fine. I'm like, no. I know what COVID feels like.
You do a good Liesl.
I
like that.
This feels very COVID-y. Yeah, Dr. Laurie was telling me, nope, this is not.
No, I can hear it.
yeah, for sure. So I then decided, you know what, let me go test because I just didn't like how it felt. And that first night wasn't the greatest night ever. I mean, it was, you know, a little bit of a headache, a little bit of a tingly throat, but the back pain and, like, the shivers. And because, like I said, it was cold, you've got chills, but you're not sure if it's because you're not dressed enough, or the house is cold, or, you know, it's just terrible weather that we're having last week. Tested, got a positive result back. Then I told the almost Mrs. Hey, listen, so we're probably very COVID positive, but we'll see how things go. And she was like, no, she's fine. It's going to get better. Oh, let's just, you know, hold hands and we'll be fine. And then, you know, surely a day or so later, she started feeling a little bit ill. And I think comparing us two, because she definitely got it with me, looking at her course for someone that hasn't been vaccinated, this is my course. I had about a day and a half of not feeling great.
You see.
She, on the other hand, I mean, she didn't have the vaccine at all. Her course was a lot more indurating. Like, I mean, she had a lot more days of fever, a lot more days of, you know, not feeling great. Like, I mean, there'd be times where I'd sit up and I'd watch her at night.
Even sound just, like, sick.
It wasn't nice. And it's not nice to see as a partner, because I think we're the great contrast in that sense, because, you know, one has the vaccine, one doesn't. My symptoms were mild more than anything else and disappeared. And she probably had a little bit and still has a little bit of like a moderate type picture going on with her, but it's slowly starting to ease down, even though you've got that residual cough, you've got the residual headache, you've got the back pain and joint aches and, you know, stomach aches and things such as that. So it's been interesting. But, you know, just to round it up back to what you asked, you do get COVID. You can get COVID. I mean, if you're either not wearing a mask or you touch a surface that someone, you know, is COVID positive on, even after you've gotten the vaccine, it's just that the course of the illness was much milder. Like, I promise,
I've seen some
of my friends much milder. It felt like a day or two of illness versus someone who, for instance, has not gotten the vaccine. They'll be a lot sicker.
And in this case,
it was lethal. But, I mean, something for her, that she was younger, has got a good immune system, you know, is a healthy bunny to start off with in any case. So she got out of it and is getting out of it a lot better than what someone who is not vaccinated would.
And that is the point. I mean, the two of you are a good case study for what it's worth. If you get vaccinated, you still can get COVID, but the symptoms are much milder and the chances of severe illness drastically and significantly reduced. Well, listen, I'm glad that you're there for each other.
Thank you.
What a way to, kind of shame, to spend your first couple of weeks as fianced. You're so happy together, and I'm so glad that you're together for each other now. And then, when you're all good, come in, say how's it to the team, and just give her lots and lots of love and kindness.
I will do so.
Cool.
I think it's good practice for in sickness and in health.
There you go. I do. Right. You do indeed. And when you get asked that question, you can say, I did. Liesl. Take care of yourself and take care of your fiancé, Dr. Musa. And I'm sure that you're going to be so much better when next we see you. I'm actually off with most of the team for next week. So we'll all be back on air together around about Tuesday the 10th. And I'm sure of that. Gaan jy baie beter voel. Kyk na yourself en baie liefde daar by die huis, hoor.
Okay, bye, liefde vir julle. I miss everyone.
I know, we miss you too. Cheers.
Get better.
Bye.
That's Liesl Laurie there with a fiancé, Dr. Musa, telling us about their journey, being COVID positive. No, man. But they'll be okay, right?
With your other family. Your morning family.
Good morning.
Breakfast with Martin. Yes, sir.